Hi. Well, I'll tell you. I begged him. He kept saying, no. Finally, I got down on bended knee. And hey, look. The boy relented. The boy George is here.
I'm here because I'm cheap and they paid me loads of money. A lot of money. It's wonderful. Tonight, BPM's at Swoon in Stafford. I'm going to be DJing tonight with Angel and Mark Rowley. So stay with us and have a wonderful evening.
And also on tonight's show, we're unveiling Portishead's new biopic. Lawyer turned DJ Judge Jules is taking the stand. And we're checking out Portrait's Moral Crusade. So let's go inside. Let's check it out. Started just over a year ago and quickly added its name to the growing list of Midland's must-see venues. It takes place at the Colosseum in Stafford and boasts a large dance floor, four bars, and a restaurant. Numerous screens and banners transform this large space, which houses 1,100 party people. The music veers towards Happy House and Garage, which this week is cooked up by residents Angel, Mark Rowley, and headliner Boy George. Promoters of this fabulous club, Ted and Winston. Now, Winston, what happened? What happened here? It's like an explosion of happy, wild-looking people.
Basically, all it boils down to is a lot of people getting together, coming in to have a good time, no attitude, free and easy, you know.
It certainly is. Ted, what sort of a music policy do you have here?
Very sort of happy house and garage.
Yeah, and any sort of a door policy?
We've got like quite a tight door policy. Yeah, we're sort of very much on sort of dress. You know, we want people to dress or make an effort.
It sure is. It's almost as though you had a stylist come down and sort everyone out for the night.
Well, I mean, people dress up because the place is nice. You know, it always reflects on the way people dress. If you go to a kind of like dungy kind of place, then well, you know, you get dungy kind of people. I mean, this is a classy place, so people dress up for it.
What DJs have you got coming down here?
Coming next, we've got Alistair Whitehead, John the Police Women, Dave Seaman, everybody.
Anybody who's anybody, yeah?
Yeah.
Mark Rowley on the decks. I'm here to tell you about a new movie by Spike Lee called New Jersey Drive. It has a wonderful R&B soundtrack and it's our video of the week, a BPM exclusive. Take it away, Spike.
Hi, we're just here in a stairwell, George and me, and we're going to have a little chat about what you've been up to lately.
This and that, love. This and that.
This and that. Now, yeah. I hear that you've got a label, More Protein.
Yeah, we've been going for about 6 years, but we've just kind of gone independent in the last year. And since we went independent, things have been going very, very well for us.
So what is up with Lippy Lou, Eve Gallagher?
Lippy's got a new tune coming out called Liberation in about a week. Eve's got a new tune coming out and an album, which is fantastic. She's a real diva. We've got a guy called Amos who's kind of been doing business on the dance scene for a while, and also a lady called Z.
Now, what about the DJ thing?
Well, I just do it for a laugh, really. I mean, it's not like my life like it is for lots of DJs.
You could play your own, too, if you wanted.
I play stuff from the label, but I would never normally play anything with my voice on, because I find that a bit embarrassing.
What about, like, Fun Time? There would be just no way.
I have played that a couple of times.
Now, I just want to know, in that video, did you, like, really shave your head? Did you make all those girls shave their heads? Were you that nasty, nasty dictator?
No, they were already bald. We actually advertised for bald girls. And I did shave my head because I felt like doing it as a half measure would have been a bit phony,
and
so I just took it all out.
Not a look we're showing.
That's why I've got my little syrup on tonight, you see. Because I'm as bored as your ass.
Ooh, what about you? Where are you heading to? Where are you DJing over the next couple of weeks?
Mostly up north. I mean, that's normally where I play. Next week I'm in London.
Is there any scene? Is that it?
I just like it up north because people are more friendly. They're more up for it. They're not so snotty.
Than where? Than down south?
Yeah, down in London, people are generally more unfriendly and all they want is banging, banging, banging.
Yeah, we don't like that, do we?
Well, I like a bit of banging, but I run out after about an hour. You know, then I get a bit lost. One of the DJs of the year. Yes, Judge Stool's the man who could talk you into a nervous breakdown. Here he is on BPM telling us all about his life.
My first gig was actually in a local, like the dance hall attached to one of our local pubs here in North London, called the Boston Arms in Tufnell Park. And it was me and a character called Rollo, who's subsequently gone on to fairly big things in dance production. We were both about 16, we were the DJs, and the average age of the clientele was probably about 13. So it was quite an embarrassing affair. In my early years of DJing, I was a law student studying law at the London School of Economics, and I kind of got into DJing via putting on illegal parties in disused warehouses, the old kick the door down and go syndrome. And it was me and Norman Jay, and when the police came along asking us what on earth we were doing in these vacant premises, after giving them some legal jargon about being a squatter, it was normally me that had to speak to the constabulary. So Norman Jay assumed that I was capable of being a judge and gave me that nickname, and it's kind of stuck ever since. I do two shows a week on KISS London and one a week on KISS Manchester, which both of which cover a sort of basically about a 50-mile radius of those particular cities. I do a thing called Judging the Jury. That's where we invite a panel of guests to come in and judge six releases in the dot, one of which is like a listener's submission. And monthly, the winning listener gets their studio time paid for, plus 1,000 white labels pressed up and help with the distribution. So that's quite a nice carrot for them. There's always plenty of well-known characters, both in terms of producers and DJs from the dance world. And it's known as quite an anarchic rioter sort of affair where people generally slag all the records off. If I get people being complimentary about one track on that feature, then I'm doing well. But in the same breath, you often catch the same DJs out there playing the records that they've absolutely coated a few weeks previous. my taste is very, very varied. I like everything from down-tempo funky grooves to sort of full-on techno, although I'm not really a junglist, so to speak. And I tend to kind of pitch the music accordingly, but always with your own style kind of thrown in. I play fairly regularly in Germany, where the taste tends to veer far more towards the hard, sort of beat-orientated tracks. And they almost dislike vocal records, period, in Germany. Whereas I could play at a garage club just as comfortably, although I could never really stick to one genre. I think very often genres are created by journalists to make work for themselves, whereas good and bad are my main monikers. We're actually sitting in the bowels of my house, so to speak. This is my sort of home studio. We do the majority of our production work here. Last year we did 33 remixes, which I recently told Paul Oakenfold, who looked at me like I must be some kind of self-inflicting psychopath or masochist or something like that. Last year was remix year. This year we've decided to devote a little bit more to our own productions. When you do something you love, it doesn't feel like a job, it feels like your life. You know, it's like a hobby that you're paid to do, and that's, I think, if the moment I stop feeling that attitude is the moment to move on, because I've noticed too many DJs around me starting to be too money orientated, and I'm not saying that I don't, you know, make a decent living, but at the same time I do it for the right reasons, I do it because I love it.
The music here at Swoon, well, I'll tell you. Mark Rowley, resident DJ, and Angel, resident DJ, who I haven't spoken to for what, a year?
Yeah, it must be about that now,
where
I reckon.
Where were we?
In Bristol the last time.
Were we hot?
I was pissed, I don't know about you.
I don't know. So, you don't need a date or anything ever, like for a Friday night, because you're always here, yeah?
Well, yeah, I do sort of play other places as well, but I try to be here as often as I can.
Where are you playing around now?
All over the place. I don't know, it's like my mind's gone blank all over.
I don't believe it for a minute. We'll be back to her momentarily. Now you've been here since the beginning.
I have.
Yeah?
Very stuff.
And you're still here. It must mean you like it.
Yeah, it's a good club, you know, it's a good atmosphere and people come here and they have a good time.
Yeah? And yeah. What about your music? Where's that headed?
Well, I first played sort of the garage deep house side. You know, me and Angel are both different in our styles and it gives it a good variation.
Mark tends to be a bit deeper on a bit of American tip, whereas I'm more uplifting. So
uplifting.
That is
more spiritual.
Yes.
You send definitely. Us. You bring us to a higher place.
Well, I don't know about that, but I do try.
Yeah. Well, Loopsters, that's it from another wonderful night at the World of BPM. And it just leaves me time to say thank you to Ted and Winston, our gentlemen promoters for the night here at Swoon and Stafford. And also I'd like to say hi to Paul Garrett from High Wycombe. Paul's just come back from living in Greece. I bet he's still got that beautiful suntan. And Paul thinks that we should check out a club in Hull called The Room. And we will, I promise. And also, well, thank you to you for being
here. Thanks for having me,
Brenda. Hey, it was
fabulous. It's been real. It's been real. Next week, BPM's going to be at the Royal Albert Hall, 15th of April, with Paul Oakenfold, Todd Terry, and Smokin' Joe. So be there, because it's the only place to be, guys and girls.
Yeah, and now what about a kebab or something now?
Well, I didn't pull, so let's have some chips.
Okay.